Hi there. So now we will discuss about thoracolumbar fascia. See, thoracolumbar fascia again, it's a stabilizing structure, and sometimes it is commonly called as biological corset. Biological corset. Corset, that means like it will support the lumbar spine. There are various names: lumbodorsal fascia, thoracolumbodorsal fascia, or whatever, but commonly thoracolumbar fascia it is named. So where it is located? It is located up the, as the name suggests, thoracolumbar region. It is a diamond from posterior view. This is a person standing posteriorly. This is the posterior view. So this is a diamond shaped fascia situated at the lumbar and thoracic region. Here it will give attachment to latissimus dorsi, both sides. And here it will give attachment to gluteus maximus. So as you can see, this and this forms a single vector to perform any rotational movement. This will help a lot. And again, it goes on to form, with the help of muscles, anteriorly. So this is thoracolumbar fascia. This is the posterior view. The attachments, see, it will attach to the spinous process, and then it will attach to the gluteus maximus. It will attach to the latissimus dorsi. It will attach to the iliac crest and goes anteriorly to attach to the abdominal muscles. It has three layers. The thoracolumbar fascia has three layers. Probably if you can see this side, I'll try to draw it. I'm making the full board. Yeah. So we will see the superior view of thoracolumbar fascia. Example, vertebra. Imagine any vertebra of any level. This is front, this is posterior, anterior, posterior. So you have the muscles multifidi, and then you have longissimus, basically erector spinae group. Then you have iliocostalis, both sides. Here you have quadratus lumborum, then anteriorly iliosuchus. So these are all the muscles which you can view superiorly. Yeah, so now we'll do the thoracolumbar fascia. From where it starts, see, it has three layers. Thoracolumbar fascia has three layers: posterior layer. Why I'm telling posterior first, but we are starting from posterior. Posterior layer, middle layer, and then anterior layer. The thoracolumbar fissure has three layers. So the posterior layer starts at the spinous process, covers the erector spinae muscle. The thoracolumbar fascia, I could have used a different color, but I'm not sure if I have it. But I'll continue with this. Imagine this is the posterior layer of the thoracolumbar fascia. You have the middle layer, which is, as I said, this is quadratus lumborum. Erector spinae. Multifidae. This is the middle layer of the thoracolumbar fascia. And then anterior layer of the thoracolumbar fascia. All these three layers join together. So posterior layer is the thickest. It will start from spinous process, covers the erector spinae muscle groups, goes anteriorly forwards. Middle layer starts from the transverse process, both the sides. Starts from the transverse process on the posterior side of the quadratus lumborum muscle. On the posterior side, it will start like this, even from here also. Posterior side of the quadratus lumborum muscle and goes on to merge. And then you have the anterior layer starting anterior surface of the quadratus lumborum muscle. It is covering quadratus lumborum, both sides, and as I showed you in the other picture, it will have connection with the latissimus dorsi. Both the sides. Then it comes anteriorly to form the abdominal muscles. So which are the abdominal muscles? The deepest is internal oblique. Three muscles you have to draw. Internal oblique, transverse abdominis, internal oblique, and external oblique. Three muscles. 1, 2, 3. And then goes on to form the rectus abdominis. These two muscles are rectus abdominis. Again, here three muscles. The deepest is transverse abdominis. Here I'm drawing little clearer. Transverse abdominis, then you have internal oblique, then external oblique. So these three layers are the thoracolumbar fascia. As you can see, it goes on to attach the anterior abdominal muscles, including rectus abdominis. So now you know the how the thoracolumbar fascia is there. So now it is easy to understand the function of this. So what is the function of this? Example, you do any movement. Example, the abdominal muscles perform flexion. Abdominal muscles perform flexion. Since this passive structure is connected to the abdominal muscles, as it contracts, this will support the your lower back. So the more contraction here it happens, the more support this passive structure gives you. That is why this is also called as biological corset. So during any movement, the muscle contraction, this more and more contraction, more and more support. So this is the advantage of thoracolumbar fascia. One more use of the thoracolumbar fascia is it connects latissimus dorsi to the opposite side, gluteus maximus, so that you can do the rotational activities. Example, bowling, like you're rotating and bowling. So that's a good example. So this is about thoracolumbar fascia. Now I will try to, if you didn't get the function, I'll try to explain with the help of a model. Thank you. So this is the thoracolumbar fascia, diamond shape, giving rise to latissimus dorsi, and here gluteus maximus. So when you go to the side view, it will go front like this, and as I have explained in you on the diagram, it will go front and attach to the abdominal muscles. So the significance of this is, when the abdominal muscles contract, flex, this will support the lower back. Come back. The more contraction of abdominal muscles, the more support to the lower back. Come back. Thank you.